When you look at this photo, nearly every object here is identified as a galaxy, and as you can see, there are a variety of shapes that exist. This photo was taken by the Hubble Space Telescope, and it's called the Hubble Extreme Deep Field, and it combines Hubble Telescope observations that were taken over a small patch of sky, and it has over 2 million seconds of exposure time, and it's the deepest look we have into the universe thus far at the time of this video. And this is the region that the Hubble was photographing, and you can see when comparing it to the size of the moon, it is a very tiny portion of the sky. And when you're looking at this photo, there are over 5,500 galaxies, some in which scientists have estimated to be over 13 billion years old. And in this video, we're going to look at the types of galaxies that can be observed, how they're classified, and examples of each type. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. Let's begin with the broad definition of what a galaxy is. A galaxy is a system of millions or billions of stars held together by the gravitational attraction between the gas and dust within the galaxy. And they're classified by their shape. And if you look here, these are the two main types of galaxies that we see. They're spirals and elliptical galaxies. However, there are variations of galaxies besides these two categories. And this is Edwin's Hubble fork diagram that it's often referred to because of how the spiral galaxies can branch off depending if they have a bar within their structure or if they're a normal spiral. So let's dig into the different types of spirals and ellipticals. So here we have a spiral-shaped galaxy, an elliptical galaxy, and then I also included irregular since they are fairly common as well. And spiral galaxies, as you can probably guess from the name, they have a spiral pattern and visible component parts. And when we look at these three main components, we have the bulge, which is the center of the galaxy. There's the disk, which are the arms of the galaxy. And then there is the halo. The halo contains older stars, the disk has younger, bluer stars, while the center of the galaxy typically has older stars. You're not observing the halo in this photograph, so I found this one of M104. It's called the Sombrero Galaxy in Virgo, and this area here would be classified as the halo. Here we could see the galactic center and then the disk-like arms, and this is a cool galaxy because we're looking at it edge-on. And remember, we classify spiral galaxies based upon their shape. So those two shapes include being a normal spiral or a barred spiral. A barred spiral has that bar structure throughout the center, and then the arms go around the center, where we don't see the barred structure in normal spiral galaxies. There are a ton of photographs out there of spiral galaxies. Here are some of my favorites. The Needle Galaxy, and then this one is so beautiful. You could see the amazing arms coming out from the center, and this is Messier 51. And this image is an optical image, but also combines infrared data, so it allows you to see where the heat in the galaxy is, along with the visible bright areas, such as the core of the galaxy. Our next classification of galaxies include elliptical galaxies. And just like spiral galaxies, they're named after their shape. They look like these fat little fuzzy footballs in some perspectives. And instead of the stars spreading out into a thin disk like in spiral galaxies, the stars wrap completely around the galaxy's heart and move out equally in all directions. So let's look at some of the characteristics of elliptical galaxies. They're spheroidal in shape, and the stars wrap around the galactic core, and they are equal in all directions. They're typically composed of older stars, and we usually don't see any new star star formation happening in galaxies such as these. And some of the largest observed galaxies are classified in this shape. And if we look at our classification fork, Hubble's fork, this is where ellipticals sit in this area. So right there, you can see some are more elongated, where some are more circular in shape. So here's some examples. We have IC 2006. I think that one is really beautiful. It kind of looks like a fuzzy star, but they're just collections of millions or billions of stars. And here is M87. This one has been in the news in the past few years because we were able to capture a picture of the black hole in the center of the galaxy. Our next classification of galaxies falls with irregular galaxies, and as you can probably figure out from its name, they have no particular shape or symmetry. They're often small in size and have younger, hotter stars. Typically, they have less than a million stars, but they're very common in our universe. Some examples include the Small Magellanic Cloud. The Large was once classified as irregular galaxy, but now it is classified as a disrupted barred spiral. And even though the Small Magellanic Cloud is a dwarf irregular galaxy, I have read that there is a bar structure within here. And this takes us to our next category, which are dwarf galaxies. A dwarf galaxy is a small galaxy composed between 1 million stars or up to a billion stars. So that's, again, is very small in comparison to our own Milky Way. Here's an example of a dwarf galaxy. They're very abundant and they have a wide variety of shapes. Here is the dwarf galaxy DDO68 in the constellation of Leo. And here's the Phoenix dwarf galaxy in the Phoenix constellation. In the next portion of this video, we're going to take a look at some unique galaxies that exist in our universe. Ring galaxies are interesting because they are galaxies with the appearance that they have just a circle of light around them. And within this area, there are no spiral arms that are attached to the core of the galaxy. The ring itself contains younger stars. They're often very blue and bright. This particular object is called Hoag's object due to the person who discovered it in 1950, Arthur Hoag, and it was identified. He thought it was a planetary nebula, which it certainly looks like one, but it was then identified as a galaxy. And what's really peculiar about this object is if we zoom in, if you look in this space right here, it looks like there's another ring galaxy within there that's perhaps farther away. But Hoag's object is estimated to be 60 million light years away. Another unique galaxy that's observed are starburst galaxies. And starburst galaxies have an exceptionally high rate of star formation. We see star formation in these galaxies that are 100 times greater than what we see in our own Milky Way galaxy. Here's an example of one. These are the antennae galaxies in the constellation of Corvus. And if we were to zoom out there, you could see that's what looks like an antenna, maybe perhaps on a bug. But these two galaxies are interacting with each other. And then because they are interacting and merging together, there is a higher rate of star formation. Another example of a starburst galaxy include IC-10. And this one is close to us at only 2.2 million light years away. It's located in our own local group. And again, we just see higher rates of star formation in starburst galaxies. Lenticular galaxies are galaxies that appear to have a circle-like appearance. The ring itself in this region typically has younger stars that are blue and bright, and these types of galaxies are fairly uncommon. If we were to look at Hubble's fork, the diagram that helps us classify galaxies, these are classified right here as lenticular galaxies, or S0. So in terms of it's a type of spiral galaxy, but perhaps very early in its development. Here is an example of a lenticular galaxy. This is NGC 4866 in Virgo. This one we're looking at edge on, and you can see there's no visible arms in here. However, there is a galactic core that glows brightly. And I found this diagram that I thought was interesting. It shows you that these are lenticular galaxies, so very circular in shape, and it is estimated that their rotation has something to do with, you know, how fast it rotates will determine what its arms will be like in the future. So this is kind of like an evolution of galaxies over time. Here's one more example. I love this one. And this is a lenticular galaxy, as you can see, almost circular in shape. And it almost looks like an eye to me. And it's located in the constellation of Fornax. And finally, I have this galaxy to share with you. It's called the Cartwheel Galaxy. And it's both a lenticular galaxy and a ring galaxy. So here you can see it's nearly circular in shape, but it also has that ring around it with the central core. So it's interesting that you can have galaxies that have characteristics of two different types. Our next type is our ultra diffuse galaxies. And these are peculiar because they are extremely low luminosity galaxies, and they vary so much. Some lack star-forming gas and typically have older stars, but then it can also be extreme when it comes to dark matter. Some consist entirely of dark matter, where some are entirely free of dark matter. So they're very unique and peculiar. Here is Dragonfly 44. This is an ultra-diffuse galaxy in the constellation of Coba Berenices. And this one is 99% dark matter. So very interesting that there's a wide variety of ultra diffuse galaxies, but what the thing that they share is that they just aren't very bright. The final type of galaxy we will examine in this video are interacting galaxies. And these are ones that are affected by each other because of the gravitational pull and influence they have from their proximity to each other. It's possible that some of these interacting galaxies may eventually merge, which can trigger higher star formation. It creates friction between the gas that exists all throughout the galaxy, and astronomers often find that merging galaxies have higher rates of star formation, much like that one starburst galaxy we looked at earlier. So let's take a look at some examples of merging and interacting galaxies. This is the Mice galaxies. These two are a pair in Coma Berenices. This right here is NGC 4302 and NGC 4298. It's estimated that these two are interacting with each other. And then the famous Whirlpool Galaxy and NGC 5195. These two are interacting and then will eventually merge. So I hope this video was helpful for you to go over the different types of galaxies that exist in our universe. And I'm really only scratching the surface. There are other varieties, but these are the ones that are the most common and piqued my interest. And it should be interesting to see what kinds of images will be produced from the James Webb Space Telescope, which has an optical portion, but also an infrared portion to this space telescope. And we've been waiting many years for the James Webb to be in space. And as this video is being recorded, all its instruments are being aligned. And I hope you're as excited as I am to learn what this telescope and the science it will produce. So I have to give a shout out to all the astronomers. And I'm sure there's many more people than just the ones here pictured. But this gives you a size comparison of how big Webb is in comparison to the people that are helped developing it. So thank you so much for watching. Let me know, have you ever seen a galaxy in the night sky? sci-fi. I know some of the most common are the Andromeda Galaxy, of course, our Milky Way Galaxy. Thank you so much for watching. I really love learning about different types of galaxies out there. So this was a fun one to make for you guys. Remember, it takes time, patience, and practice to go out and see the stars. And even though we may not see objects like this with the naked eye, it's really cool to think that we can look at a totally dark portion of the sky, and this is what exists out there. And when we are looking at images like this, we are looking back in time, because it takes light so far and so much time to reach us. So just something cool to think about. Thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, keep looking up.